Hey guys, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to create a bar graph using HTML Canvas API and JavaScript in HTML. To understand this tutorial, all you have to know a little bit of JavaScript and some HTML API, especially Canvas. I'm going to show you how to do that. Okay, let's jump into it. Before I'm going to go ahead and explain the code, let me show you what the application does. I'm going to run the application. So currently this application is running on browser IE10. This also run in IE9 and most of the other browsers without any problems. So basically this is a little bar graph that I created using Canvas and JavaScript. So the idea behind this one is, let's say, you know, you are interested to know about, you know, what really happened throughout the day in the stock market, especially related to the stock market that is, you know, technology related, such as Microsoft, Apple, or whatever. You know, this application could be made really, really useful. For example, you know, you might be, there are a lot of web services out there which you can consume to get the data, get the actual, you know, the actual stock market data based on the, you know, based on the stock market symbols such as Microsoft, Apple, or whatever. So based on that data, then you can create a graph like this. But of course, you know, this data right now is a hard-coded fictitious data, but idea is, it's really, really cool. You can do something like that by using, you know, by using Ajax, making Ajax call, or maybe using the, of course you cannot do make Ajax call right away, but you can, some, a lot of web services, they provide JSONP kind of thing, so you can use a JSON object with the padding to do that, something like this also. Anyway, let's go deep dive into the code and see how it really works. Okay, so if I, you know, collapse my big method, that's where most bulk of my code is located. So this is, you know, let's for a moment just pretend that we don't have this code, the highlighted code. Then all we have basically is a function. That function starts from here and goes here. And as soon as that's defined, it's already been called because, you know, these two parentheses right here makes it to invoke as soon as it is encountered, as soon as it is finished defined. And inside that function scope, I have a function called process stock, and that process stock function is called for the very first time right here. And after that, I have set timeout method. The set timeout method, what it does is a register stock data provider method again after 3 milliseconds, and that basically that's what causes this method to, you know, keep on running. And every time it runs, it just generates a random data as if, like, we kind of like as if the stock is really changing. Okay, let me show you the detail. So in terms of my HTML, I don't have anything special, nothing is there. Basically, I have a div container. Inside that div container, I have a new HTML5 control called canvas, and I give ID to the canvas so that I can refer to it from the JavaScript, and the width and height are set. All right, let's look into this method right here. I define some object. I'm saying to the window, hey, if this object already defined, that's fine, just assign that reference to that one into this variable. Otherwise, just go ahead and create an empty object. And once that object is defined, I'm going to create a method called color. This, because I would like to have the random color generated for each of my bar graph. That's what it does. The implementation of creating a graph is very simple. I basically grab all the hexadecimal character, go over each of them. On each iteration, I'm going to select random value from it. And once I got those 6 value, I would prepaint that value with the hash sign. That's how we assign color to a DOM object. And after that, I have a little function there. The function will give me a random number in the range of 30 to 300 pixel, and then I have to make a floor because I don't really need those other numbers. Well, I can, still works, but okay. And I'm going to define some I have another object called graphs data. and this is object right here. This object, only thing it has, this graph data has a data object, data array. So basically data array, each data array contains the anonymous empty object, not empty object, it's called anonymous object right here, with the property like company name, the stock symbol, and the stock value. So get the stock value, I call the random number. In so basically we'll have, every time it runs, we'll have a number in the range of 30 to 300, which is provided by this little utility method right here. That is that. And I have another little object called coordinate. That's my initial value. I have to decide where I would like this, my canvas to appear, my graphs to appear. And then I'm gonna say, hey, give me the canvas reference to the canvas object by using getElementById. And then this local variable of the canvas context, I'm define it and set it to null. And I'm saying, okay, if there is a canvas, if the canvas is supported by the browser, it comes in here. And then, you know, this is very, very important right here. Usually, I don't really call like get context by 2D, because, you know, a lot of browsers might not support get context method. So so that's why there is a guy called Paul Iris. He's a really amazing JavaScript developer, I assume. And then he has a lot of videos, and they have created a library called Modernizer. It's an amazing library. It's a really, really useful library for HTML5. Basically, what this one does, hey browser, do you support this? Do you support this? Basically, it says, can you once your canvas is created, you're gonna ask that, is get context is defined? If defined, good, awesome. If it's not defined, then you have to look for the second option, whether somebody else has written API, kind of like canvas, that you can use for the older browsers. Okay, that's the idea. Of course, here I'm not using the modernizer, but I highly, highly recommend to use it. But I know this one works because I'm running in the IE10 browser right now. So okay, and after that, I need to know how many datas are there in my object. And so, other important thing that you have to know when you're drawing the canvas, because like if you must clear the rectangle if you want to draw it again. Otherwise, if you draw a canvas again in different location, different x and y coordinate, it will be overlapping the previously drawn canvas. So make sure you have to clear it. Clearing a rectangle is pretty simple. You're just going to specify the, you know, starting the left hand corner 0, 0, that is x and y, and the entire width and height of the canvas. That's it. And after that, I'm going to go over all my objects and on each iteration. Okay, if you support the canvas, great. And then I have this color method defined in my object, and I'm basically calling that and assigning the value to this local variable called graph color. And this block of code right here is responsible for drawing one graph. On each iteration, a multiple graph is drawn, of course, you know. But the idea is I have to change the coordinate on each time it runs. So I have a coordinate, and I have defined like x is 20 starting from, and you know, this is where the y will be starting from. And I need to know that how big the width of the canvas, I mean my rectangle has to be. That's this method, and finally the how tall it has to be. And I give the color to rectangle, and then finally say fill it and call the stroke method. When you call the stroke method, it is drawn on the canvas. And after that, from those objects, I also like to know which company name and the symbol of the company, which I would like to, you know, like put into a text, you know, after at the bottom of the graph. And finally, I also like to the value, actual, you know, stock value on the top of the graph. That's what is done by right here. And well, sorry for that. That is done by this method right here. Idea is very simple. To do that, I call the, I give the font, and you know, I'm saying, okay, it has to be you know, this big font, and this is the type of the font is Arial, and I was like, what color I want to fill this with. And this is where I want to draw. When you're going to draw, you're going to say what you are drawing, and you're going to give x and y coordinates. That's it. And each iteration, I have to increment my x coordinate because I have to, you know, do a certain offset. I have to move towards the right on each time I draw the rectangle. Once that is done, I finally would like to draw something like this. I need to draw this one, this little text right here. To do that, of course, I call this fill text method, give this, you know, string, and I will say this is the starting from 200 from the left and 365 down from the Y coordinate. That's where I want you to draw. Okay, that's the first iteration. And